another evening of sculpting. I'm going to be continuing to work on these gangbusters that I had started last week. And I think what I'll be doing is starting with this one here. She has a lot of armor that I need to sculpt on still, so based off of this character. As you can see from between now and the last screen, I actually cut back the hair because I realized that he didn't really seem to have as much of a flat top as I wanted, or his fade didn't look right. So what I'll be doing is copying this chest armor, as well as trying to copy this back armor. I will also need to copy the neck shoulder armor, and I'll probably hold off on doing the straps for a moment. As you can see, the strap kind of goes over there, and there's kind of a little buckle right there. So I'll be waiting to do that, I think, until after I've done all the other armor. So with that said, I think I'm going to work... mix up some green stuff. I also used a little bit of brass rod here to basically be an armature for the ponytail. Once I start working on that. So I think first thing should do is work on that back plate. That's pretty simple. And I guess it's actually pretty complex because it has that writing on it. But shape itself, I think, is a little more simple because I don't have to work on doing any type of layers. Actually, it looks like the kind of the neck shoulder side guards might be the best place to start. So I'm going to try and mix out and pull out just relatively equal sizes. It's supposed to be symmetrical. I'm kind of thinking that these will be more than enough. So I'm just going to do one first. I'll put the other one in my little piece of plastic over here. That's it. These are actually going to go a little bit higher than this neck guard on the back is. So, I'm just going to put the green stuff there for now. I'm really having a hard time focusing today. I mean, it tends to not be great, but seems like it's hopping in and out more than usual. I'm going to go ahead, put that down. I'm going to go ahead and take this other half, put it on the other side, because I do think that this will be enough. We'll see, but I am hopeful. So it's just a little higher than this neck part. Back of the neck part. Thank you. That's a lot of green stuff. Sculpting is just a lot of back and forth. Getting something just right. Screwing it up and then having to do it over again. At least that's how my process seems to go. to be pretty thick, so I'm gonna put a little bit of more green stuff on there. But I'm gonna have to just kind of work it back and forth in to get it to integrate without leaving a kind of gross seam. twist this to the side, because it's going to be pretty troublesome while I'm trying to work here. Get a nice, decent, crisp edge. so I'm gonna let that settle there for a little bit more before I go on to the next, before I really start adding the detail, because right now it's still really, really soft. Just a slight mismark will just really mess things up, so I'm gonna let this just kind of chill out here for a minute. I'll go back in and add the, I don't know what you call them, but they're kind of like these little grooves, like little light grooves or something. And then I'll try and add in that text. That text is going to be difficult. I think everything I could do pretty easily except this, the O. That always makes things a lot more difficult when you have to make a circle with green stuff. Make it a flat line, it's really easy, but circles can be difficult when you're just kind of etching them in, because of the way the material moves, you almost end up with a like, weird twirl, and getting them even is also fairly difficult. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and move on to the front armor. He's got this thing, kind of comes down, and then looks like it goes in like that. see with just the shine of the metal, but he's also got some of those little light things right there and right there. So similar thing to like what's here, but on that front, which I really didn't notice at first. Too large. The square and then kind of where that right there is what I'm trying to get, and I made mine way too large. So I just do one thing real quick. I don't want her hair to be so slicked back, so I'm actually gonna cut this away. Just so I have kind of a place to give her some bangs. So I'm just going to try and do much of this is going to be covered by those pouches. I do want to give her some more pouches as well. But I do want to try and get this as close as possible. Right now, it just looks like she almost has like an angry bunny on her face. I mean, on her stomach. this is probably a bad idea to try and start this part of the armor. But I'm gonna see if I can get away with it. This is kind of the main chest plate. fun gargling sink. Just at that point where it's still sticky, but not sticky enough to actually go where I want it to. You know, I think I'm actually going to do this just by painting, because I'm trying to etch this is, I don't think it's going to end well. Is that going to be the right size? It's just not gonna look right, so I'm gonna go ahead and not put those letters in, and I will paint them on. This isn't a piece I'm trying to cast. I think if I want to put those letters on, I really need to do this part as its own step and spend a whole lot of time on it, which it's not great for a stream, because all I'd really be doing would be hitting those letters, messing them up, and redoing them. And that would be the entirety of the 2-hour stream, which I just don't feel like is that useful to anybody, including myself. Take a break on her and jump over to the other guy real quick. And really what I need to do with him is just build up this chainsaw, or this, not chainsaw, this minigun a bit, and where the arm connects. So I'm actually going to pop him off of this. Actually, I'm going to remember another tool for this very purpose. I just do hold tiny things. I can work on them. I think what I'm going to try and do tonight is just stabilize this a little bit, because again, it's got that weird casting error that makes it look pretty flimsy and not long for this world. So I'm going to see, this might actually be RDB2. Too dry at the moment, but we'll see. Yeah, these little surgical clamps are great. I just got some pretty recently. Quite a bit more handy than the for these little parts than screwing a than using a drill handle. Keeps showing me a poor connection, so I'm not sure how clean this video is, but hoping it's all right. I'm going to do is just make this ring a little bit fatter, I think. And maybe add some connection points. But I think my time is running out on this green stuff here, so I don't know how much longer I have it that will be that useful. So the connection points I'm going to do are going to be kind of large and will not sit well on. I think it'll be difficult to blend them on and put them on while this is still curing. So I think I'm going to go ahead and call it an evening, and I'm going to do one more thing, which is just to take a small bit of this. I kind of want to make it into something I can cut into a rectangle. Because I want to make a decent looking ammo feed for that gun as well. That gun arm. So one other thing I could do real quick, now that I think about it. This is actually exactly the kind of thing that this amount of green stuff, like this kind of endgame stuff is exactly. Stuff comes in handy. So I don't want to have to mix up a whole new batch for what I'm about to do. But I do need the green stuff, so. So this little gun was from a sniper. For some reason they made it so small. It actually works pretty perfectly. If you cut it down, it works pretty perfectly as a submachine gun. Just a little bit of modification. I think that's pretty much done. I might need to go in and sand some things afterwards to get them nice and smooth. But I think that's going to be it for the evening. I feel like this is looking pretty good. I just really need to work on the hair next and finish up with some straps. So pretty happy with this, and I think I'm going to call it an evening. Thanks, y'all, for joining. Have a good day.